Black hole on Jupiter? A few days ago, a massive dark spot was found on Jupiter. The buzz was on! Is it a bird? Is it a black hole? Nope, it is a shadow? Recently, the Juno cam on board NASA's Juno spacecraft got success in capturing some of the stunning images of Jupiter. In the series of pictures captured by NASA's Juno spacecraft, a massive black spot was seen atop the gas giant's churning clouds. While this might have looked scary initially, scientists have now agreed that it's a shadow cast by Jupiter's extremely volcanic moon, Io. Io is also the most volcanically active body in the entire solar system. It is very close to Jupiter and needs just 42.5 Earth hours to make a complete orbit. It is said that Jupiter's moon is about the same size as Earth's moon, and the shadow is quite similar to a solar eclipse on Earth. However, because of the gigantic size of Jupiter, it appeared more like a shadow. This shadow is more of an annular eclipse because Io's shadow is not even close to covering Jupiter's entire surface. However, the image is quite big, given the fact that Io is only slightly larger than Earth's moon. The pictures were captured by Juno on September 12th, while participating in its 22nd perigeux, or close encounter, with Jupiter. The NASA spacecraft, which arrived at the Jovian system in July 2017, is in a highly elliptical polar orbit that brings it close to the gas giant's cloud tops and then out again into deeper space. This image was processed by Kevin Gill, a NASA software engineer who has also produced other stunning images of Jupiter. As explained, Juno was around 8,000 kilometers from the surface of the planet when it captured these images. In other news, Juno is currently scheduled to perform around a dozen more perigeux before the mission ends in July 2021.
What would happen if there were a black hole on Jupiter?
Jupiter is often referred to as a failed star, but with some super massive size engineering, we might be able to make it our next sun! All that we would need is a black hole. We'll tell you how. The idea of turning gas giants and other celestial objects into stars has been a tantalizing concept floating about in the world of astronomical journals and science fiction for years after years. The concept has come to be known as stellification, and Jupiter is the best candidate in our solar system for this kind of transformation. The fifth planet from the sun has only 1,000th the mass of our star, but it has 2.5 times the mass of every other planet in the solar system combined. It also has ready-to-fuse hydrogen and helium. If our human civilization ever got to the point where we were star makers, where we could stellify Jupiter, there's a chance we could start harnessing vast amounts of energy from this new sun, or even use that human hat starlight to terraform Jupiter's moons. There are a few ways we can make this happen. Option 1. We call Jupiter a failed star because when the gas giant first formed, it was only lacking the mass, and therefore, the gravity necessary to pick off thermonuclear fusion. For example, if future spacefaring humans could find and gather 80 times the current mass of Jupiter somewhere in space, we could start feeding it this extraterrestrial protein until Jupiter got enough super gains that it could flex into a star. However, 80 times the mass of Jupiter is still 200 times more mass than all the other planets in the solar system combined. So, even if we were able to give Jupiter more mass and make this happen, we might not be able to find that mass anywhere near us, or at least be able to move it to Jupiter, because it's so much no matter how much we're able to lift. So, that's a doozy! Moving on to option 2, the ignition of Jupiter. There are situations where something catastrophically energetic like a nuclear blast could potentially cause the runaway fusion of a planet's entire atmosphere. If we knew all the right numbers and had the right nuclear device, there is a situation in which we could launch a nuclear weapon at Jupiter, and then when exploded, it would start to fuse all the hydrogen and helium in the atmosphere and set the whole world on fire, kind of like a star. However, because Jupiter still doesn't have enough mass in this situation to sustain these fusion reactions, chances are this nuclear fire would just snuff itself out. Tricky, and should we say, controversial. And on to the third option, and the one with the most success rate is… If we might be able to turn Jupiter into a star is by using black holes because of their incredible ability to get energy out of matter. Yep, you heard us right! Black hole is the key! Black holes are among the densest things in the known universe. If you had a big, big black hole, it would be 600 times more massive than the moon, and it would have extreme gravitational influence. And because of this extreme gravitational influence, matter within the vicinity of this black hole would start to free fall towards this object at a high-speed free fall. Exactly like the speed of light! Most of this matter, though, will not be falling directly into a black hole. It will be more like orbiting around it to veer towards doom and fall straight into the black hole. This high-speed matter will have to slow itself down, and as it does that, that kinetic energy will be shed as heat energy. As all this matter races towards oblivion, it forms what is called an accretion disk, where all this matter is smashing up against itself before it falls into the black hole, heating itself up to incredible temperatures. For example, with a rotating black hole before this matter is destroyed, it can release up to 42% of its equivalent mass energy. For example, the amount of energy we're able to get out of mass from nuclear fusion is less than 1%. What do you know? You could even throw a jar of Nutella into this black hole, and the energy we could get out of it could power the United States for 4 hours. All of it just from one jar of that Nutella. We always knew there was more to our favorite Nutella than its delicious chocolatey cholesterol. So, this incredible conversion rate is going to be our power source. Our first step towards stellifying Jupiter is the non-trivial task of capturing one black hole. It would take seriously advanced technology, but if future humans could locate and move a black hole inside of our solar system, the next step would be to place that black hole inside of Jupiter's core. Once inside, the black hole would start slurping up all of the matter and all that gas and create its own accretion disk, which would create the energy that we need for stellification. However, you can't just throw a black hole into Jupiter, because it would punch right through. As we said before, black holes are terribly massive and dense for their relatively small size, and so if you were to just drop a black hole into Jupiter's gravity well, it would just punch right through like a cannonball. Instead, we would want to put our black hole in some kind of orbit around Jupiter, one that would eventually take it to the thick layers of atmosphere and terminate at the planet's core. This may take around a century of time or more, but hello! We're renovating the solar system! It takes time, come on! And the scale is important here too! We do not want a giant black hole at the center of a galaxy for stellification because it would just obliterate the planet. How? Black hole accretion disks can get so hot that they can outshine literally trillions of stars! Black holes need only fit within the width of a single human hair! For this case, we only need a microscopic black hole, and once this black hole gets orbited to the center of Jupiter, it would start siphoning the abundant hydrogen and helium until an ultra-hot plasma is formed around this teensy-weensy black hole in space-time. As gas from Jupiter tumbles violently down into our microscopic black hole, it'll bump into itself and shed energy and carry a tremendous temperature. You may think that Jupiter could be immediately consumed by this kind of process, like you may have seen in the movies, but it's actually regulated as heat is generated in the accretion disk. This heat pushes on all the other material trying to fall inwards into the black hole to create more heat. This then reaches some kind of equilibrium point called the Eddington limit, where the heat energy pushing outwards is now equal and opposite to the gravitational pull pulling directly inwards. At this point, this is as bright as a black hole can get. Stellar irony, huh? Eventually, over a cosmic-sized completion time of a few million years, the black hole burning away at the core of Jupiter would raise the average temperature of the planet to over 1,000 Kelvin, and it would shine with the dull red light of a pseudo-star, and voila! Our solar system would now have a second sun. A black hole star in our cosmic backyard wouldn't just change the Jovian system. It would give you another reason to go out at night. In less than 100 million years after Jupiter's stellification, three of its icy Galilean moons, Europa, Callisto, and Ganymede, would reach average temperatures similar to the average temperature of Earth's water. Vapor and carbon dioxide would start to enter their atmospheres, and geological changes along with greenhouse gas effects could make these tantalizing worlds potentially habitable for humans and habitable for millions of years. If only, Jupiter! If only!
Couldn't hurt to daydream, right guys?
Today it is a shadow, but tomorrow, who knows? What if the great grand cosmos surprises us? Tell us down below how you like the video. And hey, did you know that there may have been an advanced civilization preceding ours on this planet? We'll leave you with that cliffhanger, and let us know if you want us to talk more on that.
To infinity and beyond!